Hi, it's Ashley from AB Sound Advice. Today we are doing a product preview on the Olbark XXL Fusion Banana. Now this is not to be muddled up with the fruit. This is a banana plug that plugs into the back of your speakers. So pretty cool. It comes with a pack of four, so effectively this will do one end. So if you've already terminated your amplifier, but your speakers you tend to be moving all the time, you want to be able to unplug them. These are fantastic. And again, XXL is a 5-star rated product from Olbark. And if you haven't heard of Olbark, they've been around for over 40 years. They're in over 40 countries worldwide. 30-year warranty on all their cables. And again, they run a star rating. So 3-star for performance, 4-star for excellence, and state-of-the-art is the 5-star. And clearly, this is state-of-the-art. Now, I use these myself on the end of my speaker to cable. So this is a situation where you want to use your own cable now. So you might have your own, you've got some cable that you're existing, or you're going to upgrade to a cable, but you want to cut your own length this time. You can then just buy two sets of these if you want to terminate both ends, meaning to the amplifier and the speaker, or you just terminate directly on your amplifier, and then you can put these terminations down at the speaker end, just so you, for the ease, you can unplug them. Sound-wise, of course, I do feel there is probably a really reasonable benefit in actually putting the connectors on. And if I mentioned to you before, I do love having the proper connection. So if you've got the ability to do so, then do it. Sometimes on your home amplifiers, you may be so close to the wall or wherever you are that they would stick out too far, so you're forced to put it in its traditional housing. But on the speaker side, it's a great thing. If you do need to quickly unplug a speaker or move it aside or something, it's always a lot easier to be able to just unplug them. It is to go to the trouble of unwinding the posts, getting them out, and then putting it all back the way you found it again. So more of an ease thing, but sound-wise, again, it'd be very good. And as I've said before, I would buy these for no other reason than they're German-made, German quality, and of course, I love the finish. So they also provide, which I think is quite cool, they've got a little bit of a little plastic protector, so when they're not in use, you can put the connectors on to protect them. When they are in use, of course, you would just push that into the back of your unit. Now, keep in mind, too, if you notice that when you go to plug this into the back of your unit on your amplifier or your speakers and you find it will not push in, if you look carefully, there'll be a little red and a little bit of black plastic, depending if it's the positive or negative. Some of them you will just be able to put a little razor blade behind it or a little blade screwdriver and click them out. Other ones you have to wind the binding post straight off, then you remove it and then put the winding post back on, and then you'll be able to use these. So if before you go ringing up your hi-fi store and saying, hey, I can't push these in, just have a look at the back of your binding post and you'll see a lot of them do have a protector. Some brands don't do it at all. Other brands do have a little tiny plastic thing that you do have to click out. Once that's out, these will push straight in. And by the way, they can also be on the amplifier end. So both ways, just check to make sure that that's been removed. Other than that, very cool little connectors. And again, I love these sorts of little knick-knack type things, and very hard to find videos and information on this stuff, even locally. But I think it's cool because at the end of the day, I've always loved electronics. I've also loved all the gadgets and used to build amplifiers back in the earlier days. So, and also speakers. And as a matter of fact, my first enclosure I built for a home audio pair of speakers would have been maybe 1979, 1980, somewhere around there. And speaker design, and I've also built speakers myself. So I've built enclosures, built boxes, and built amplifiers. So at the end of the day, this is a great little setup. If you want to make life a little easier, then I would definitely go down this road. So I hope you've enjoyed today's product preview. If you like more information about the Olbark, just duck onto olbark.com. And again, thank you for tuning into AB Sound Advice.